2014 is truly the year of Kevin Hart, as he stars in three movies. You're watching Beyond the Trailer's review for the first at bat, Ride Along.
James, I wanted your blessing in asking your sister to marry me.
Show me that you're worthy of her.
How am I supposed to do that?
I'm gonna take you on a ride along.
Today is your training day. Have you ever even held a gun before?
Bang, bang. I'm more of a shotgun specialist.
Be careful, that's got magnum loads in it.
You gotta get on the ground! Oh! My stomach and my ass!
Oh yeah, you're ready for the streets.
Yes, this year you can see Kevin Hart in Ride Along, About Last Night, and Think Like a Man 2. Plus, Grudge Match from Christmas 2013 is still in theaters. But two of these movies are also directed by Tim Story, who's keeping pretty busy himself these days. Story got his big break with Barbershop back in 2002, which ruled the box office 3 years before Tyler Perry made his first movie. And unlike with Perry, the big studios came a-calling, with Story landing high-profile directing gigs Taxi and the Fantastic Four movies. Sadly, though, they were also high-profile bombs, with Taxi getting a flat tire at the box office, while Fantastic Four was rejected by fanboys and mainstream audiences, its sequel actually making about $50 million less than the original. So Tim Story found himself returning to the smaller, largely African-American films that Tyler Perry can't seem to escape. He wasn't associated with Barbershop 2, but started his comeback with Hurricane Season, starring Forrest Whitaker. But then, with Think Like a Man, he found himself with another big box office hit, and, just like that, was back in Hollywood's good graces. So he's directing Ride Along and Think Like a Man 2 this year, both starring hot new comedian Kevin Hart. Ride Along co-stars Barbershop star Ice Cube, who had a string of hits, but like Story, could use a comeback himself. It's also worth noting that Ice Cube is a prolific movie and television producer. He's a producer on Ride Along, while Kevin Hart produces his comedy documentaries, as well as his own TV show, Real Husbands of Hollywood. Looks like more and more these days, if you want to make it in any part of the entertainment industry, especially emerging markets, you have to be a multi-hyphenate. So Ride Along exists in that weird limbo we're all familiar with when it comes to movies. And that is, if you were to rent Ride Along, you would think it was a real gem, a true find, and you would tell all your friends, and you'd think, you know, maybe I should have seen this in theaters. But if you actually go and see Ride Along in theaters, I think you're going to walk out going, I could have rented that. Now, that's not to say Ride Along doesn't have its strong points, most notably Kevin Hart. He's very good here. He got me to laugh out loud several times, which is, I think, what a comedy's main goal should be. But beyond just being funny, he really fleshes out his character. I cared about what happened to him. And in fact, I cared about everybody in this movie, which I think is a testament to the cast. Ice Cube was also very good, particularly good as a straight man to Kevin Hart's Joker. Tim Story, very good, solid directing job. And also a very good script. I mean, not a great script, but a throwback to the tighter screenwriting of maybe the 80s and 90s, where things there are not only callbacks, but things come back into play later on in the film that you wouldn't expect, and in a good way. Also, another nice thing about the script is that I was a little curious as to how they were going to redeem Kevin Hart's character. I didn't want them to turn him into like a super cop, kind of like, you know, yesterday I reviewed Jack Ryan's Shadow Recruit, and one of my chief complaints about the movie is that Jack Ryan could do anything. He had no flaws. But Hart plays a very real, flawed character. And I do think that the movie figures out what to do with him without betraying that or not ringing true. The other thing, though, one fault the movie does have, though, is that it starts with a pretty decent car chase over the opening credits. And you might think, well, how is that a fault? And I think the reason is because it raises the bar just a little bit too high. When the movie began, I was like, oh, wow, this might actually be a legitimate action movie. And it's not. It's a comedy. It's more comedy than cop movie. And actually, the movie it reminds me of quite a bit is The Heat from this summer with Melissa McCarthy and Sandra Bullock. Not only because it's, you know, that kind of a pairing, it features an up-and-coming hot comedic talent, Melissa McCarthy, now Kevin Hart, but also in terms of the film's ambitions. Both of them are small films on the small side, without any really huge set pieces, and they really are focusing more on the comedy and the character interaction. However, one thing that does differentiate The Heat from Ride Along in a very good way, I think, is that The Heat really played up the fact that it was female police officers. And there were a lot of jokes about that, and it was always very in your face, that you were dealing with women characters. But Ride Along really never plays the race card. I think there are maybe one or two jokes about it, but really, it's, you know, really this movie could be about any characters. And I think that's great. And I think that is a direction that these largely African-American cast films are moving in. And I hope that more demographics come out to see that, they hear that. And it's a film for everybody. And I think that's great. And I think it's something that
this, I mean, I don't want to say genre, a lot of you find that offensive, and I can understand that, but this type of movie, it's a direction it needs to move in, I think, to get more universal appeal. But as for Ride Along, as I said in the beginning, I think it's going to make a great rental, but it's an okay movie-going experience. And so that's my thoughts on Ride Along. If you've seen the film, leave your thoughts down below. Thank you for tuning into my review, and you can watch some more episodes right now.